Friends, what is NPSC? I, Akash, going to tell you about the NPSC. NPSC is Nagaland Public Service Commission. The Nagaland Public Service Commission was set up in 1965 with a composition of one chairman and two members. The composition was revised in 1985 by addition of more members. In 2007, the strength of members of the commission was increased to 4 members. Presently, there are 1 chairman and 4 members. Let's talk about brief discussion about NPSC, that is Nagaland Public Service Commission. Nagaland Public Service Commission is a body which is responsible to conduct the examination for appointments to the services of the state, and commission shall be consulted by the government on all matters related to methods of recruitment to civil services and for civil posts. Let's talk about the eligibility criteria for Nagaland Public Service Commission. So in eligibility criteria, first we'll talk about nationality. So let me tell you, friends, that all citizens of India or Indian nationals are eligible to apply for NPSC civil service. Now, it's about educational qualification. Any graduation or degree from a recognized university of India or equivalent qualification is valid for NPSC, or any equivalent degree or 3-year qualification equivalent to graduation is also applicable. Now, as far as age limit is concerned, so it is the general age criteria prescribed is that candidate should be between 21 to 30 years. There are some age relaxation also provided by Nagaland Public Service Commission to some categories, and these are like for SC or ST candidates, age relaxation is for 5 years. For those candidates who are desirous of entering NPSC civil services cadre but presently serving in another government position, the age relaxation is equal to the number of years they still have in their service. The maximum number of years in service should not exceed 5 years. Now, as in every civil services exam, number of attempts are there. So let me tell you, friends, that there is no specified limit by the commission on the number of attempts a candidate can make. The only condition is they have to strictly adhere to the upper age limit as specified by the commission. Now let's talk about the very important part of the commission, that is basic pay scale. Now we will talk about post wise. So first, for extra assistant commissioner, it is from rupees 15,600 to 39,100, and grade pay is of rupees 5,400. For DSP, that means deputy superintendent of police, rupees 15,600 to 39,100, and grade pay is of rupees 5,400. For youth resources officer, rupees 9,300 to 34,800, and grade pay is of rupees 4,600. And for station superintendent, it's from rupees 9,300 to 34,800, and a grade pay of rupees 4,400. For station secretariat assistant, it's rupees 9,300 to 34,800, and grade pay is of rupees 4,200. For research assistant, it's from rupees 5,200 to 20,200, and grade pay is of rupees 2,800. And let's discuss about last post, that is research assistant. It's from 5,200 rupees to 20,200 rupees, and grade pay is of rupees 2,800. Now let's talk about the examination pattern of Nagaland Public Service Commission. So the Nagaland Public Service Commission civil services examination consists of 3 stages of the exam. They are the prelims, mains, and the interview of personality. So first, let's discuss about prelims exam pattern. So let me tell you, friends, that it is objective type of examination. Answers have to be correctly indicated on an OMR sheet. The preliminary exam is conducted for a maximum of 200 marks, and negative marking is applicable, and 1/3 of the marks will be deducted for selecting the wrong answer. After this, the candidates who clear the prelims exam successfully, they will get the ticket to sit in the mains examination. So let's discuss about the pattern of mains examination. The mains exam consists of 3 papers. Each paper carries a maximum of 200 marks. General English, General Study 1, and General Study 2 are the 3 papers of the examination. The first and third paper are descriptive. The second paper is an objective type of exam with multiple choice questions. So friends, negative marking is applicable for the second paper only, as it is objective type. 1/3 of the marks will be deducted for selecting the wrong answer. Now it comes about last round, that is interview round. So let me tell you the details about interview round. After the main exam round, the commission will decide the cutoff marks of the exam based on a number of factors. These factors include the number of candidates applied, the number of candidates appeared for the exam, toughness levels, etc. There are other factors also which affect the cutoff list. After the cutoff marks are set, all those candidates who stand above the prescribed cutoff marks will be called in for the interview round. Here, the candidate will be screened by a panel of interviewers based on his personality, suitability to the services, interpersonal skills, etc. Now, let's talk about the syllabus. So, first, let's discuss about prelims examination syllabus. So, it includes science and technology based questions, Indian history, history and culture of Nagaland, geographical data of India, Indian constitution, politics and administration, India's struggle for independence, and latest news and general aptitude tests. Now, let's discuss about mains examination syllabus. So, it consists for general English, essay-based questions on any two common choices of topics that are currently favorable in social, political, economic, or current affairs selection will be asked. For general study 1, study on modern Indian history, various data based on statistical analysis, all details pertaining to the state of Nagaland, including history, geography, economic, and social features, science, as we perceive in everyday lives, etc. And last paper for general study 2 paper, detailed studies on Indian administration, constitution, rules and regulations, politics and laws, policies, economic structure and functioning of India, financial growth and fiscal policies, Nagaland administrational structure and organization, etc. Now, let's talk about interview. So, there is no fixed syllabus for the interview round. Candidates can be asked any question about the demographics, cultural, social or political, economical spheres of the state of Nagaland. They may be asked questions pertaining to their skills also. They may be questioned on their area of study at the graduation level too. So, anything can be asked in the interview. Any other detail, any other information if you want to get about Nagaland Public Service Commission, so you can visit its official website also, that is npsc.co.in. And for more updates about the various civil services examination, stay connected to our education.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates on time.